I was born on February 15th, 1833, in Boston, Massachusetts. I was the last of five children, the four before me all girls. My father, being a man of science, firmly believed that the odds would finally dictate the birth of a long-awaited son. He would be named Michael. I was named Michaela. I was determined to attend medical school, but none would admit women. I finally received my MD from the Women's Medical College of Pennsylvania. To my mother's dismay, my father made me a partner in his practice. And for 7 years, we worked side by side. Until... when he died, I lost my advocate, my mentor, my best friend. My mother would say that he'd spoiled me. I would say he'd given me the freedom to be myself. Our practice virtually disappeared. I was afraid my life as a doctor was over, but I'd promised him to carry on.
Enough is enough, Michaela. Your father is gone, and so are his patients.
They were my patients, too.
Your father, God rest his soul, indulged you in a fantasy.
I have a medical degree, Mother. That is no fantasy.
In this world, it is.
Then maybe I belong in a different world. I found an advertisement in the Globe for a town doctor in the Colorado Territory. Thank you, Laura. I sent a telegram detailing my experience, and in less than a week, I received a reply offering me the position. It was the frontier, a place where people made new beginnings. A place where my services would be needed, where my skills would be appreciated, where I would finally be accepted as a doctor. Across that vast territory, I could feel civilization receding behind me, slipping away with each turn of the wagon wheels. My father taught me that different customs, language, or color of skin were not causes for prejudice or hostility. But as I saw real Indians for the first time, I could not reason with the knots in my stomach.